Okay, so thank you for coming at this round table in this last day, late afternoon. In this round table, so where does Global Meet Local, we would like to discuss about how we can find a common ground for analysis. With multi-scalar analysis of settlements and land use dynamics. So we will see three cases, extremely different actually, but addressing the same type of question that I remember you to have it in mind when they will present. What are the factors that can explain the settlement distribution and its change over time? And how do these co-evolve with the land use in terms of space used to get or to produce resources. We will have three presentations with three types of approach actually. Data-driven approach, purely theory-driven approach, or mixed approach. So we will be able to discuss about these three types of approach. And of course, the question for us is how to bridge the gap between the gap when we are asking our research question and at the second level when we are looking at actually at the outputs of the model or the outputs of the records we are analyzing. So I will ask each contributors to present in about 5 minutes their case studies about, okay? And now, but the idea is to have some time after to discuss. So, Philippe, we will have all the three presentations,
yes,
and then we will have a general discussion?
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Clément?
So Clément will present one case study in France concerning Middle Age period.
Hi everyone. I am happy to be able to contribute to the discussion on how to reconstruct landscape dynamic based on the analysis on several scales. So this work was carried out within the framework of the SOLIDAR program, and the study area is in the center in the France and is covered by forest mainly. And was covered by LIDAR, and I show the survey area in red on this picture. The survey area is located west and south of the Blois city, and mainly on the left bank of the Loire River. In this sector, the forest of Chambord, Boulogne, and Russy, and Blois, so we form a surface about 25,000 hectares, in which the Chambord estate was created during the 16th century. The earliest mention of this forest, is all this forest, date from the end of the 12th century. On the LIDAR data, it's quickly became apparent that three occupation frames were superposed on the major part of the LIDAR acquisition. Here, for example, you can see in the foreground the current parcel frame system. I put them in green. And this frame overlaps a system of embankments and ditches in blue. You can note that finally these two systems overlap another system composed uniquely by embankments. I put it in red. And this system is organized in tiny rectangular entities. These elements are 15 meters wide for 10 to 15 centimeters high, so the human eye is unable to recognize this artifact on the field. The morphological variability between these three systems suggests a different use of space. The two more recent systems, the blue and the green, are dedicated to hunting and forestry activities. And the most ancient, the red one, correspond to an open landscape dedicated probably to agropastoral activities. If in the forest there is a clear overlapping between the different frame systems, providing a relative chronology of land use, what happens in the open space? Here, on a particular sector near Ruisseau-sur-Cosson, we can see that the embankment system is found inside and also outside the forest. The remain of this embankment still cause photographic anomaly, here, for example, and correspond to the street system and crop square limit visible in the cadastre from the 19th century. I superpose to Boucher. The shape of this system is really characteristic and corresponds to agricultural district, a shape well known in this part of France. This example allows the hypothesis of the continuity of the system until the 19th century in open areas, while it was fossilized by the establishment of the forest. In addition to the traditional dating of the building linked to the parcel frame from the collection of ceramic shards, a field campaign in order to obtain data by OSL method was initiated with the objective of characterizing and adopting to date some visible slopes on the LiDAR data by opening perpendicular trenches. The agropastoral vocation of these elements seems to be reinforced by the cross-sectional observation of an increase in the silty clay layer, or a destoning, or even the presence of a composite structure. The terminus postquam of the implementation of these structures is dated between 180 and 670 and correspond to the expected date of the implementation of these elements during antiquity or even during protohistory. The terminus antiquae for the end of the implementation is estimated between 100 and 1550 and partly correspond to the period of establishment of the forest, but you can notice that finally the end of the development of these structures is correspond to a date after the creation of the forest. So these results invite us to ask ourselves about the speed, of course, of installation of wooded areas. Indeed, the dynamic of formation of the forest are unknown to us with textual and archaeological sources alone. The shape and the continuity of the forest, the use of wooded areas in the Middle Age being varied, fruit harvesting, grazing, hunting, etc. And of course, the true limits of the wooded massif during the medieval period. The combination of these elements make it possible to propose a restitution at large scale of the dynamic of the occupation, which is weighted by the permanent round trip between the different scales. These frames composed of embankments appear to be structures by a large northeast-southwest axis, here, of about 20 kilometers long on the left bank of the Loire, and this axis is intersected at more or less regular intervals by perpendicular lineaments every 1,500 meters, with an average of about 1,100 meters. The northeast southwest subdivision appear. Okay, it's finished, of course. Generating square module with a surface area of about 1 square kilometer. This little structures, and it has so far been possible to find only one habitat per module, which, assuming that the grid and habitats have worked during the same period, could suggest that each corresponds to a square module. Okay. The comparison with the Beaugency frame, which is situated 15 kilometers upstream, reveal a number of analogies. This frame was detected from the 19th century parcel anomaly, so it is of course less fine. And we observe finally the same structures with the main axis following the axis of the Loire River and divided by axis space between 500 meters to 1500 meters. So the same finally delimitation than in the Chambord region. In the case of the Beaugency, the excavation of some habitat, I put the habitat already excavated in black, revealed the sites operating from the protohistory to the high middle age, which is similar to the results obtained in our study area. So, in conclusion, the scale change. Even if it may provide us contradictory information at first glance, allows us to nuance our interpretations and fill in the gap the coverage. Thus, it is able to totally renew the understanding of the implementation of this space. Thank you for your attention.